You will not believe what I did in this video that almost got me thrown in jail. Okay, people say I'm a little bougie for a plumber. Look, I don't even know what bougie means.
You keep using that word. I don't think it means what you think it means.
But I tell you what, I do know what I like. Let me ask you this. Have you ever tried a bidet toilet seat? I literally took a bidet toilet seat with me to Fort Lauderdale, Florida, drove up the road a little bit, checked into the hotel, and as soon as I checked in, well, guess what? I installed a bidet toilet seat. So I want to show you exactly how I did it, but first I want to explain a bidet toilet seat to you. Those of y'all that don't really know what a bidet used to be a fixture installed next to a toilet. It had like a lavatory faucet on it that you set on it and you turned it on and, well, it would squirt you and clean you. Men in the backside, women front or backside. These new bidet toilet seats are an add-on. They do the same thing. They've got a reservoir in here to keep the water and let you set it to the temperature you want. Also, your seat is heated. Again, set it to the temperature you want. Now, you can also determine your seat temperature, your water temperature, the spray strength, meaning what kind of pressure comes out of it, and the nozzle position. So as you can see, the seat gets to 100 degrees. Now, I know that sounds hot, but in the middle of the night, when you come in to sit down, it's actually really not. So this seat has power supply. That's one thing about this. You're gonna need an electrical outlet somewhere near the seat. Now, you can watch some of these electricians on YouTube and they'll show you how to tie onto the light switch, run a cable down to where you're actually installing an outlet right by your toilet. That's what I did at my house. 70% of the toilets in Japan have a bidet toilet seat or they're a full-blown bidet. Now, here in the United States, we've got so many toilets installed without bidets installed next to them. What most of the big suppliers have done have created a bidet toilet seat where you literally just swap out your toilet seat, plug it in, let it get warm, and power it up. With a bidet toilet seat, you press the button. And guess what? It cleans you. Sometimes maybe more than you want it to. So, this thing, I'm telling you what, it's really pretty cool. I'm gonna show you me installing this in my hotel room before I remembered to put out the do not disturb sign in the maid called security and, well, anyway, that part of it, we kinda left out. You look kind of funny going through the airport with a toilet seat box with you and standing there at the luggage. Well, people give me some funny looks. But here we are, beautiful morning, Fort Lauderdale. It was neat to get up and watch the fish every morning. And I know everybody thinks I'm bougie because I want a window seat. I want a view of the ocean. So here I did. Soon as I got there, I started taking off the toilet seat. And once I got it off, man, it really didn't take that long to do. Now, I fought these nuts just a little bit, but it was nothing crazy. So then, there we go. I open up the Big Daddy. I have got my bidet toilet seat with me. And it's funny because when I told people down at the event that I was at that I had done this, they all thought that I was crazy. So first of all, you take off the other seat, shut off the water, flush the bowl, get everything out of there because you're going to have to disconnect it at the fill valve. So I stuck a little towel down under it, disconnected it, did everything that I needed to do. Now, this is a pretty neat trick. I take the screw and start it in the rubber there, dip it in the water, and literally push down on the screw. It extends that rubber bulb out where it slides right in there, then pull my screws out, line up my seat, and as you see, I'm kind of centering it between the seat and the tank because I've installed these before, so I know about where that works out. Take the screwdriver, tighten it up so it does not move around. Once you get that done, literally, disconnect the water, and I've got a towel under there that you can't see, but you see that little bit of water that comes out? We want to make sure we got it all. I didn't want to make a mess. I didn't want to leave anything going downstairs. Put the bidet T in, tighten it up to the fill valve, and then hook your water supply line back up. At that point, it's literally very easy. Slide the seat in place. It will lock in. Then you attach your water line to the seat,
and you've got connectors there to attach it to make sure the pressure does not blow it off. And of course, then you clean it up, make it look good. Now, I did have to run and get an extension cord. I didn't carry an extension cord, and I did not carry a screwdriver. So I had to make a trip over to the local hardware store, which when you're out of town like that is an Uber drive. Took a trip over to the hardware store, got what I needed, came back, and literally once I did that, it was easy to do. Tightened everything up, plugged it in, got my remote control, put my batteries in, and I was looking good. Actually, I was sitting pretty. And yes, I like my seat hot. I like my water hot. Spray strength good. Nozzle position all the way out. And man, I got to tell you, there's nothing better than taking care of yourself. And like I said, a lot of people think I'm a little bougie, but at the end of the day, I'm a plumber who knows what he wants. So if this is something you'd like to do, maybe not in your hotel room, either in your hotel room or maybe at home, you might be careful. I did have a problem when housekeeping came in, found the seat that I had laid up under the lavatory, and they called hotel security because they didn't know why I'd taken it off. But luckily, I was able to talk my way out of it. So anyway, if you go out of town, if you're on the beach and you know you might get sand in places that you'd really like to clean out, installing a bidet toilet seat may be a great opportunity for you.
With 125.7 million people in Japan, 88 million people, guys, they can't be wrong. I mean, think about this. What would you rather have? Dry paper rubbed on your backside to clean yourself, or rinse it with water and then just dry off? So whether you're using the front or the back, you can make that nozzle come out and go right where you want it to go. Why are bidets so important? Well, it gets down to cleanliness. Me, that's what I want it for anyway. I want to know I'm squeaky clean, which is just a clean thing. I get it. But guys, I keep going back to that thing. If you put your hand down in dog poop, what would you do? Would you just use paper, wipe it off, and go eat a sandwich or something? Probably not. Well, why do you want to just wipe your tail off with paper and then walk around the rest of the day like that? You know me, well, call me a little bougie. Other people have, but I know what I want. This is a great thing to have. This is going to help improve your health in the long run. Call me bougie. Call me whatever you want. But you know what? I call myself clean and comfortable. If you like this video, you're probably going to enjoy that one.